What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the FTB Essentials Minecraft mod. FTB mods are known for completely changing Minecraft's gameplay, so if that's something you've looked for in the past, you've probably come across a few of them. That being said, FTB Essentials is a bit different. Since this mod adds a variety of player and admin commands to teleport, visit warps, set homes, and more, instead of actually changing the gameplay itself. It's a different way of enabling cheats on your server, but with a lot of added features. To start the download process, visit the FTB Essentials CurseForge page and press Files at the top to view all of the available downloads. Scroll down to find the file you want to use and then click download on the right hand side and save this file to a safe location to use in just a minute. After that, you're going to download the matching version of FTB Library and Architecture API. Now to install it on the server, head to your Apex server panel and stop the server and make sure the version you're running matches the mod that you downloaded. After that, enter the FTP file access on the left-hand side, and on the next page, enter the mods folder and press upload in the top left corner, and then drag and drop all of the mod files into the upload area. Once they are 100% uploaded, you can use your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel where you can restart the server. Now, unlike with a majority of mods, FTB Essentials is entirely server-side, and it actually does not need to be installed on the client. However, this will show you a red X when you're joining the server, which you can fix by installing the mod anyways. Before you start, make sure you install the matching version of Forge client-side, and then open your Minecraft launcher and head to the Installations tab. Hover over your Forge profile and click the Open Folder icon, and in the new window, find or create the mods folder and enter it. Paste the FTB Essentials and all of the dependency jar files here, and then you can return to the launcher and press play. Once the mod is loaded and functional, you're going to be ready to use the new commands in-game. While some of the commands are going to be available by default, others will require additional permissions to use, such as opping your player. These miscellaneous commands aren't really going to help you progress in the game, but they are very helpful features to try to experiment with. Cheat commands are the ones that are actually going to help you progress, whether it's by healing your player or flying around in survival. And teleportation commands are, of course, used for teleporting. These commands can help you get from one place to another without having to manually fly or walk to your desired location. If your server is endlessly starting up or crashing, there's probably an issue with one of the uploaded mods. Make sure that all of the mods are for the exact same game version and that both dependencies are added to the server. Architecture API is available for both Forge and Fabric, so make sure you are only downloading the Forge version. If the commands aren't working on the server, this might mean that the mod is not loading properly on the server itself. First, make sure the server is set to run the matching version of Minecraft Forge, and then make sure the mods and the dependencies are all uploaded into the mods folder. If the only issue is that you can see the commands but you're not able to execute them, it could be because you don't have operator privileges. If you see a red X when you try to join the server, this is because this is a server-side only mod and you don't need it on the client. In most cases, you will be able to join normally despite the error, but if you hate seeing the X on your screen, you can get rid of it by just downloading the mod on your client. Most FTB mods are known for their crazy changes to the actual gameplay and world. And while Essentials doesn't hit all of those marks, it has its own charm in all of the helpful commands it offers to players, making it the perfect mod to add if your players need a little bit of extra help. That's all for this one, and of course, don't forget to like, subscribe and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all of our future videos.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.